My name is Adam Torbicki. I'm from Poland. I'm a cardiologist. I am 66 years old, but young otherwise. All started when I was still a student because we were faced with a lot of patients with acute pulmonary embolism, so acute pulmonary hypertension, which were dying without the correct diagnosis. So it started with acute cases, but then I realized that there are also many patients with chronic pulmonary hypertension of different types, and that they require diagnosis and management. And this went on from this pulmonary embolism story. When I was young, I was attracted by echocardiography, and I was trying to find the way to diagnose non-invasively pulmonary hypertension with this method. And when I was performing my research, I was also contacted by a small group of experts from the World Heart Organization Task Force, which was focused on non-invasive diagnosis of pulmonary hypertension in lung disease. This was a very strong group, and I've learned a lot about pulmonary hypertension from them, and they learned a little bit about echocardiography in PH from me. The new association, which is based on our previous experience from the World Symposia on pulmonary hypertension, in fact, is a kind of development of this idea and trying to move towards more continuous work, because we were working every 4 to 5 years on the new documents. Now we hope to be interactive through all these years which separate the congresses, and we may be planning some research ourselves, maybe focusing on new areas which we think might be interesting in the future, in order to move the whole field forward and help our patients better. I am a believer in precision medicine. We are now using quite simple tools, I would say somewhat similar to medieval tools. And we have a great potential in studying what is really happening in human organism by, for example, evaluating metabolomic reply to normal functioning of all the organs. This can be done by studying breaths, the contents of human breath or blood or urine, but in a much more sophisticated way that is done now. So we will be trying to find patterns of small changes rather than big changes of single biomarkers. I think that this might be useful both in diagnosis, differential diagnosis, and also assessment of prognosis and of the effects of treatment. So I think precision medicine, personalized medicine, will also be very important for pulmonary hypertension.